This is the story of a film that was never completed. A film designed to serve as propaganda for the Third Reich, that empire infatuated with a camera that knew so well to document its own evil, passionately, systematically, like no other nation before it.
When I saw the 62 minutes 4.5 years ago, I was shocked by the fact, not only by the power of the images, but also by the fact that I was not aware it existed and it's accessible to the public.
A full decade after the end of the war, East German archivists began for the first time to sort through what remained of Hitler's propaganda machine. Thousands of films discovered in the exact location in which they had been stashed, a concrete vault hidden in a forest. It is also there that one lone copy of a film was found, over 1 hour long, with no soundtrack, no opening or closing credits, only a brief title, The Ghetto.
The ghetto was established in October 1940. Then they built a wall that separated the ghetto part from the Aryan part where Germans lived. They made the Jews move into the area of the ghetto, which was 4 kilometers square, and I think that inside were living something like 400,000 Jews. This film is actually being filmed in the last stages of the ghetto before, 2 months before starting the big deportations to the extermination camp in Treblinka, which was nothing but extermination camp. You could not walk there.
The great achievement of this film as a filmmaker, not only as a documentary, was the weaving together of the variety of scenes so that everybody now sees the more than 1 hour of film in its entirety with poignant commentary. The commentary, first of all, of survivors who were actually there. We're 1 minute to midnight in the life of survivors.
Those survivors remember the event of the filmmaking, which is quite incredible because this event was rather neglected one inside all what happened there.
Mein Film teilt noch das Ghetto. Jede Szene wird einregissiert.
Die zu bekommen am mehr natürlichen Effekt haben sie geschossen in die Luften, die die Menschen sollen laufen, der Schockene.
Another source of information is diaries that were written by intellectual Jews during the times of the filming. And again, provide us a lot of information about how it was staged and how they felt to be extras and actors inside this circus.
3 maja 1942 roku. O 10 zjawili się filmiarze z propagandy. Zrobili zdjęcia w moim gabinecie. Zainscenizowano wejście do mnie interesantów i rabinów, etc. Potem zdjęto wszystkie obrazy i tablice. Na moim biurku ustawiono 9-ramienny świecznik, w którym wszystkie świece były zapalone.
I succeeded to find an interview with the cameraman, the very same person that stood behind the camera, and he described how he felt when shooting the images we actually see.
Mir ist zu keiner Zeit bekannt geworden, zu welchen Zwecken die von uns abgedrehten Filme benutzt werden sollen. Dass sie Propagandazwecken dienten, war mir natürlich vollkommen klar. Zumal man ganz extrem den Unterschied zwischen armen und reichen Juden hervorhob.
What also is stark and fascinating about the film is the juxtaposition of the scenes of the reality of the Warsaw Ghetto in all of its depravity, with its starvation, with its misery, with its hunger, with its despair, with the created scenes in which there seems to be romance and luxurious apartments, which were clearly staged. It is a tough film, and that means that it doesn't sugarcoat anything. You feel proud of having seen this film, but also drained. You cannot go through this film without feeling yourself pushed and tugged, shaped and shaken, and feeling that you've come almost as close as we're going to come to visually being there.